this year. A spokesperson to give the student address is Danielle Burton.
Woo!
Distinguished guests, family, friends, faculty, and Doctor of Pharmacy graduates, good morning. It is a great honor to be speaking here today. I am truly humbled, and I'd like to thank my classmates and, for the first time, fellow doctors for this privilege. I'm so grateful you could all be here today to celebrate this exceedingly special occasion. Our accomplishments and place here are just as much the fruit of your labors as they are ours, and for that reason, I would like to start by saying thank you. Everyone present, faculty members, families, friends, partners, mentors, and all those that could not be here with us, your unwavering support and belief in our potential have propelled us through this journey that was pharmacy school. Without you today, the dream of today would have remained just that, and we are forever grateful. A unique feeling that defeats definition emerges around the time of graduation. The feeling is a novel combination, a mix of great accomplishment, greater relief, and also the inevitability of change. It is a time of some selfishness where we ask ourselves questions like, where will we get a job? Where will we match? Where will we live? What laws do I have to learn? And for the crazy ones of us that haven't had enough yet, where will I go to school next year? It is also a time of reflection and immense gratitude. It carries with it memories and hopes collected over the last 3 years, 7 months, and 29 days. 3 years, 7 months, and 29 days of laughs, tears, integrities, PowerPoints, praying for snow days, pre-exam cramming, post-exam conners, and the promise of becoming something greater. 3 years ago, it was the first day of our P1, our first professional year. It was the first day that the paths each one of us set out on to get to pharmacy school converged. And it was the day that our personal, individual journeys collided and combined, and together we embarked on this journey to get to exactly where we are today. In a $250,000 black gown with olive accents. At the start of our P1 year, we donned our white coats for the first time in this very hall, which confused our families and made them believe that we were finally done and finally pharmacists, but oh, we had only just begun. The real thing we finally started to do that year was try to pronounce generic drug names and figure out the aliquot method of compounding, two skills many of us are still trying to complete. Our second professional year blurred into the third as our grit and perseverance were tested through 12 straight months of CDM and some other classes that we took. We spent most of that time in front of our laptops, newly outfitted with exam soft and most likely plugged into a highly desired seat near an electrical outlet in the snow. As we got better at matching drugs with disease states, we were introduced to the JCPPPPP. We wrote soap notes and interpreted Chem 7s, and collectively we spent hundreds of hours in line at Starbucks and Curry. But we rooted for each other, we helped each other, and we recorded lectures on our phones when integrity was down due to lack of attendance at 8 a.m. CDM 4 lectures. We fostered lifelong friendships as time passed and brought us into our fourth and final professional year. This year, we took our talents outside the classroom for clinical rotations. We went out into our communities, into hospitals, clinics, and the pharmaceutical industry, where we tasted the joys and tribulations of real practice and clinical decision-making, and finally, the assurance that perhaps through all these years, we had learned something, and it stuck. For many of us, as we leave Northeastern, our formal education has concluded. Today, we will leave this hall and go out into the world, and there will be no more classes, no more long days at rotation sites, no more labs, not another assignment or test. Well, two mildly important more tests. But from here, we're no longer required by a certain objectives, certain standards, to self-reflect on our achievements and our failures and focus on areas where we can improve. The responsibility to start our real education, to lead professional lives of service and scholarship, to honestly reflect and better ourselves shifts to our shoulders. We must hold ourselves accountable to continue to grow and to learn, but I hope as we leave here, we never change. As our time together ends, I encourage you to go and continue to be the kind, patient, persevering, talented, and passionate people that I know you are to be. Just look at all that we have achieved so far. There is no challenge ahead that we cannot face. You are smart enough, talented enough, and good enough. There is no limit to the places we will go and the impact we will make. My classmates and my colleagues, thank you for the impact that you've made on me. I love you all, and I will miss you all, but I look forward to our paths converging again, because as we all have learned, pharmacy is a very small world. Congratulations and good luck in all of your future endeavors. We actually did it.